let's talk about hiding content using the ecosystem. I want to show you a new way to hide content. We used to keep content in a hidden block that appeared as an extra menu down below the main menu. The problem with that was that it didn't actually hide the content from the search function in Drupal. It just hid the content from the menu. So now we have something called hidden node. Hidden content is shown in the menu. It's still visible, but it's formatted to be struck through and the titles are less saturated with color than the titles of open content items. These struck through items are hidden lessons here, and they're hidden from students. They're also hidden from the Drupal's search function. So students can search through the content, but they won't find anything that's not already open. So now let's look at how to hide two things, a page and a whole lesson. To hide a page while you're working on it, you need to be in the edit mode. So let's go to a page in lesson one here. We'll go to the lesson one overview. We'll enter the edit mode up here at the top using the black bar. And we're going to scroll down below the editing window. It ends here to this area. We're looking for these buttons here, and for this one in particular, hide content. So I'm going to click hide content, and then I'll see this little button, this little box. If I check this box, students will no longer be able to see the page that we're working on, and they won't be able to search for it either. And of course, you can unhide the page whenever you're ready. I'm not actually going to hide this page, so I will exit without saving, but if you click this box, you want to save your changes so that they hold. So I'm just going to return to the view mode, and nothing has changed. This is still open, not struck through over here. All right, the other thing to do is to hide an entire lesson. So to do this, you want to hover on this content button up here in the black bar and choose books. And then you'll see in the outline designer the list of books for this course. Choose edit order and titles from the operating list for the book. And, oh, I messed that up. All right, so choose from the operating list for the book you want to deal with, which in this case is the course outline. And then, as you can see in the outline designer, there are hidden lessons here at the bottom. Hard to read. Lesson 8 and lesson 9 are here. They're just grayed to show you that they're hidden. So to hide a whole lesson, let's look at lesson 7. You want to click on the tool icon here to access the top level of the lesson. So click there, and what I'm looking for is hide node. So if I click on hide node, I'll get this pop-up box, and I can choose hide content and propagate hidden status, both of them. Propagate hidden status is a function that propagates your choice down the tree. So if you have hidden content at this top level, propagate hidden content will hide the items that follow on the list, all the child pages. Similarly, if you choose to unhide content, propagate hidden content will transmit the unhidden status down the list. I'm not going to actually click these, but if you did, you'd hit submit, and then lesson 7 would be hidden. And that's really it. I'll return to where I was here. Lesson 7 is not hidden. That's the process. All right, thank you. If you need a style we haven't thought of, or if you have questions about anything involved with our ecosystem, please contact your learning designer.